Hi, I'm Mr. Beat. I'm one of the subject matter experts here at Chegg. In this video, we are going to see how firms in oligopolistic markets compete or cooperate and how that affects market outcomes. An oligopoly is a market structure in which a few sellers offer identical or very similar products. Coordination among the sellers is advantageous but difficult to maintain. The case of OPEC is an excellent example. If all countries coordinate and restrict their oil supply, they can obtain prices as high as that of a monopolist. Once that coordination is achieved, however, each country has an incentive to increase its oil production. By cheating, in fact, it could sell more at a high price. If all countries did the same, however, the cartel would quickly collapse. The resulting competition would drive prices and profits down substantially. There are many ways in which firms in oligopolistic markets compete or cooperate, and many economic models to describe them. We'll look at three of them in more detail. In a Cournot duopoly, each firm decides how much product to supply to maximize its profits. But the market price also depends on total supply, which includes its competitors' production. Therefore, each firm's optimal choice will depend on what its competitor does. Cournot competition is common in industries with limited product differentiation. For instance, oil producers outside of OPEC often closely watch OPEC's strategy and then adjust their oil supply. In a Bertrand duopoly, firms do not have much power over the quantity offered, but can easily change prices. Think about two airline companies competing over the tract from New York to London. It is a direct flight, and not much can differentiate their service, except for the ticket price. Therefore, the two airlines have an incentive to continuously cut their prices. This fierce price competition can lead to a perfectly competitive outcome, even with as few as two firms in a market. While in the other two models of competition, we assume that the competing firms are identical or very similar. In a Stackelberg duopoly, one firm dominates a market before a smaller one joins. In that case, the first mover can usually capture a greater share of the market. This type of competition is common in technology markets, like the market for operating systems. Microsoft used to be a dominant firm, and its competitors, including Apple, used to serve smaller niches. Let's compare market outcomes. In a Cournot duopoly, the market price is lower than what a monopolist would charge, and firms produce slightly more than what a monopolist would produce. In a Stackelberg duopoly, the total output is larger than that of Cournot, and the market price is lower. The fierce price competition among Bertrand duopolists brings the market price and supply back to the perfectly competitive scenario. Since prices are higher and the quantity produced is lower than in perfect competition, society as a whole is suffering because some of the potential gains from this market are not realized under these oligopolies. That creates a deadweight loss, the fall in total surplus that results from a market distortion compared. The formula shows how you can calculate the deadweight loss under each market structure when demand is linear and supply horizontal. By doing that, you will see that a Cournot duopoly will generate the highest level of deadweight loss, graphically corresponding to some of the shaded areas, blue and red, when the marginal cost is zero. It is followed by a Stackelberg duopoly. Its deadweight loss corresponds to the red area. A Bertrand duopoly instead is socially efficient since it replicates the outcomes of a perfectly competitive market. So we have seen how there are many ways to compete in oligopolistic markets. Visit us at Chegg for more videos on this and other topics, or to speak with a subject matter expert one-on-one. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.